Explicit unconnected messaging is typically used for setting up and configuring a device because it gives you access to every parameter in the device. Setting up the device is not time critical, and you can be confident the parameter actually got to the device because it uses TCP/IP protocol, which guarantees delivery of those parameters. You would then typically use implicit connected messaging to actually monitor the device once it's running, because connected messaging provides periodic updates and requires no effort on your part to get the data. It just appears at your local controller. Implicit connected message delivery isn't guaranteed because it's UDP, but if you don't get a drive speed or amperage update when you're getting several per second, it's not a big deal if you miss one every now and then. Explicit message can be set up as connected messaging to give you periodic updates, which is cool because it's still using the TCP/IP protocol to guarantee message delivery, but it adds a larger burden on the processor because it has a lot more bulk in the messages and handshaking, which you usually don't need for periodic updates. This video is about explicit unconnected messaging, so let's focus on that. With explicit unconnected messaging, you're in complete control, which also means you have a lot more work to do. You have to generate each and every message in ladder code, you have to monitor the tags to see if the request is successful, and you have to dig up all the device-specific parameters for each and every message. Once you understand how it all fits together, though, implementing explicit unconnected messaging in the Productivity Series controllers is easy. Before we do that, though, there is a lot of terminology you got to wrap your head around with this explicit unconnected messaging. So before we do live examples, we're going to back up and look at the big picture. This video covers all these concepts. With other videos, we have live demos showing you exactly how to use unconnected explicit Ethernet IP messaging to configure things like variable frequency drives. For the purposes of this video, let's assume that we'll use a Productivity 3000 as the client and an Allen Bradley PowerFlex 40 variable frequency drive as a server, and that the PowerFlex 40 drive is equipped with the Ethernet adapter module to make it Ethernet IP compatible. Appendix C of that Ethernet adapter manual summarizes everything we need to know about how to access the data in the PowerFlex 40 drive via Ethernet IP. The first table in the appendix breaks stuff up into these objects. An object is just a generic way to describe things that share common features or attributes. We'll look at the details of these specific objects in the next video where we do a live example with the PowerFlex 40 drive. For now, if we look at objects in general and we use the example of drive parameters, the drive parameters all have similar attributes, right? Each parameter has a name, a value, a min, a max, a data type, etc. These are all attributes we can use to describe each of the drive parameters, so we can use a template like this to describe each parameter. Here's drive parameter 31, for example, with his values filled in. His name, his current value, etc. Keep in mind, I'm just making these numbers up for now. We'll look at real data in the next video. Here's another one, parameter 32, the motor nameplate frequency. Again, uses the exact same template and just fills in the blanks. How about parameter 39, the acceleration time? Same thing. Parameter 40, deceleration, same thing. So we end up with a huge group of tables like this, describing every parameter in a drive using this common attribute template, which we call an object. Now, what can I do with these attributes? Well, I can get the value, set the value, reset the value, etc. We call those services, all the things you can do to this common set of objects. So since all these instances of this common template or object share a common set of attributes and services, we group them together into a common class of objects. We call this the parameter class. Now there's one more template that we need. This one describes the attributes of the class itself. It tells us the revision of this class, the total number of parameters in this class, and some other things we might want to know about this group or class of objects. So again, the template describes a generic object, and a filled-in template creates a single instance of the object, like parameter 31. That's an instance of the object. Here's another instance, another instance, another instance. So suppose for a moment we want to get the value of parameter 31. Well, we look up at the manual and we find out that the parameter class is number 15, or 0F hex. The get code is 0E. The instance of this object that we want is number 31, parameter 31. And the attribute we want is number 2, the value. We simply hand those numbers to the explicit message instruction, and it fetches the value of that parameter for us. The cool thing about this is since every Ethernet IP drive uses the exact same messaging with this exact same set of templates, you can use this exact same instruction in any drive, not just this one. So once you understand how to use this, All of a sudden, your world just got a whole lot bigger because you don't have to learn a new way of accessing every new device that comes down the line. You just specify an Ethernet IP-enabled device, and the code you wrote for one manufacturer's device will be easily ported over to any other manufacturer's device. That's huge, and it makes you much more productive. Now, each class has its own set of predefined tables, but you access each one the same way. For example, let's look at the Identity class. This is used to identify different components in a device. In our device, we have the host drive itself and the Ethernet adapter. You might even have another communications adapter module connected to the drive. How would you get the vendor ID or the device type or the revision or the serial number? Well, you would use this Identity class. Here's the predefined template of attributes. Now the vendor just fills in the blanks to create an instance for each object. Here's the drive instance, so I can now go look up all these things about the drive. Here's the Ethernet IP adapter instance. And again, you might have some other communications modules. The drive manufacturer will create one of these instances for every option available. And since they all use this standardized template, along with a standard list of services and class attributes, anyone that wants to know about the identity of one of these objects knows how to get it. You as a programmer just issue a command that says you want to get, from Identity class, the revision of the host drive. We'll see how to get those numbers in the examples in the next video, but given these numbers, we just issue an explicit message command, and Ethernet IP messaging retrieves the revision of the hardware for us. If you're super ambitious, you could even write a program to query and fully auto-detect and configure an entire Ethernet IP system without knowing anything but the IP address of each device on the network, because you can ask every device who he is, what type he is, and then configure him appropriately. Very cool. What other kinds of classes of objects are there? That is, groups of things that behave similarly. Well, if we look at that Allen Bradley VFD, for example, it looks like there's an assembly object, a register object, and a whole bunch of others. Do you need to know all of this? No. In fact, most of the time, all you're going to care about is the parameters object so you can set up and configure the drive. We'll do several examples of that one, and maybe a couple others in the next video. The key thing about this is, once you get the hang of using these classes of objects, you'll be able to use them on any Ethernet IP-enabled device out there. That includes other manufacturers' drives, encoders, remote I/O, other PLCs, packs, etc. And of course, the Productivity series of controllers makes it super easy to do. Well, that ought to be enough to get you oriented. Check out the other videos in this series to see some live demos of the Productivity 3000 using explicit unconnected messaging to communicate with devices like this Allen Bradley PowerFlex drive. Performance plus value. That's productivity from Automation Direct.